And so we're ready for the shootout. Canada is the home team and will shoot first. It'll be Seth Jarvis from Winnipeg, who plays for the Portland Winterhawks, to shoot first. Again, a five-round shootout. Under IHF rules, after the fifth round, you can start using players over again. In comes Jarvis on Jesper Wallstedt. Jarvis in, shoots, misses.
Good goaltenders just hold their ground. And Jarvis tries to get it up and over the shoulder. He does, but can't get it under the bar.
Daniel Lundman, open the scoring in this game for the Swedes. Moves in, scores! And the Swedes lead 1-0 after one round.
Comes in and he just picks that spot right over the pad under the blocker.
Here's Perfetti. He has scored twice in the game. Lead determining goal scoring. Perfetti works in. Scores! What a move by Perfetti.
I can tell you what, Jesper Wallstedt's thinking to himself, what just happened there? And you're going to see what just happened there. It's just unbelievable. Oh, he moves it one way and as he's opening up right between the legs. Oh, what a brilliant player he is.
Helga Grans, a defenseman now for Sweden, moves in and he's stopped. So 1-1 after two rounds.
A little fake, but Tristan Lennox was not on his heels at all.
Quinton Byfield walks in, backhand shot goes wide.
Quinton Byfield is a very good player with very good hands. But you get in tight like that, you appreciate even more Cole Perfetti's magnificent in and around the net.
Eric Hedlund scored the game-winning goal for the Swedes against the Slovaks. Moves in, and he's stopped by Lennox. Still 1-1 after three rounds.
Loses the puck, just no chance. You're going so slow.
Hendrix Lapierre from Gatineau, Quebec, plays for Chicoutimi in the Quebec League. Chance to give Canada the lead. Lapierre in, stopped by Wallstedt.
We saw earlier how Cole Perfetti opens up Wallstedt. And when he opens up the legs, he's able to put it right there. Well, Lapierre tries the same thing, but he doesn't open them up enough.
In comes William Eklund to give the Swedes the lead again. Eklund in, shoots, and he's stopped by Lennox. On to round five we go.
Lennox is down here.
He's hurt.
Yes, he is.
Very slow to get to his feet. As he does, Canada's Connor McLennan will shoot. In round five, McLennan shoots and Wallstedt makes the stop. Now we'll see about... Now the Canadian staff is asking for a ton for time here to check on Tristan Lennox.
Here comes Kevin Elliott.
The shooter for the Swedes will be Nybeck. He's got a chance to win it here.
Well, William Eklund came in, and right away after Lennox made the save, a push.
Canada's backup goaltender is Dylan Garand.
This is very, very interesting. Clearly, Tristan Lennox was in discomfort.
Nodding at Kevin Elliott, the athletic therapist, but...
I'm not so sure the puck didn't get out the inside of his leg, where there's no padding.
He's gonna stay in. And now... Zion Nybeck with a chance to win it for the Swedes. What a moment here.
Yes, it is.
Canada 3-0. Steamrolling through the competition, but now needs a save here to stay alive. Nybeck in, lifted it high and wide, and Canada survived.
Tristan Lennox does not look comfortable.
He's really struggling. Now, we move on past the fifth round. The Swedes should shoot first here now. They'll reverse the order, and you can use anyone you want now that you used earlier.
Lundman, who scored the only goal for Sweden in the shootout,
moves in on Lennox. Lundgren shoots, stopped by Lennox, and now Canada has a chance to win it. It'll be Perfetti.
Well, who holds who? Perfetti's old wall stat this game.
Score on two breakaways, score in the shootout. And a chance now to send Canada to the final. Cole Perfetti works in, the puck rolled on him, backhand shot stopped by Wallstad. On to round seven.
What a showdown. Puck just kind of skipped, but Wallstad moves really nicely with him. Lundgren again.
Lundgren again. Chance to give the Swedes the lead. Shoot, score! This is round seven. Perfetti moves it on Wallstad. Holds and scores again.
Visions of Mora.
This is very much So Perfetti has that long, elusive hat trick.
How about Tristan Lennox? After stopping that shot by Eklund, hanging in there, making the saves. We talked about the World Junior 2007. We now have a Cole Perfetti moment at the Hlinka Gretzky, just like we had a Jonathan Toews moment that lived forever.
So the Canadians live to fight another day. They'll take on the Russians tomorrow in the championship game here in Breslau. Cole Perfetti, two breakaways in regulation, scores three times in the shootout, and Canada wins it to advance.
What a battle. Really unbelievable. Lundgren, the Swedish forward, versus Tristan Lennox. Cole Perfetti versus Jesper Wallstad. Look at that. That's joy. It's relief.
Well, a quick turnaround for Canada tomorrow. There'll be some questions about Tristan Lennox and his status for the game tomorrow. But Perfetti, who scored 37 times as a 16-year-old in the Ontario League this year, he is a goal-scoring sensation in the overtime, or in the shootout, in regulation and in the tournament. Jesper Wallstad is the player of the game for the Swedes, as he should be.
The last 30 minutes of the game, Jesper Wallstad had to be really good, really sharp. The
Swedes will play their chance for bronze tomorrow.
The best player of Team Canada is player number 21, Cole Perfetti.
Not much doubt about that one. Wow.
Yeah. How about how calm and cool and collected he was through the shootout?
Ian Wallstad, who went nose-to-nose in that shootout four times. Perfetti scored three of them. And so it's on to the championship game for Canada against the Russians. On the opening day of the tournament, you wrote me a note and said Canada versus Russia for gold. Now, your prediction has come true. Tristan Lennox gutted it out in the shootout.
sure did. And I just love the coaches, too. Magnus Haglund and Michael Dick. They just said, hey, this is what it is. Your guy, my guy. Your guy, my guy.
And so at 11 a.m. Eastern time tomorrow, it'll be Canada-Russia for gold here at the 2019 Olenka Gretzky Cup.